He started with a $50 promotion from PokerStrategy.com, started on PokerStars, and he grinded his way up. He's a three-time winner of the Sunny Million, which is an epic, epic accomplishment. Let's crush. Today, I'm going to be sharing my top 10 power ranking for my favorite tournament players, so to speak. I mean, this is not very objective. This is very, very biased, of course, and you should take it with a grain of salt. This is not a transparent list, and I'm not really paying attention of how much money someone has been winning or how many scores he had. For me, it's a combination of how many years someone has been around, consistent results, but also, of course, the hands we played against each other. So there might be players out there that might be better in theory or might have had better results, but they haven't been so long for a very long time. So yeah, I really wanna reward the grinders mentality, the legends of the game. And so let's dive right into it. Top 10, Hello Totti. Big name, a true legend. He is from Russia. There are not a lot of facts known about him. He is currently ranked around 30th in the world. His highest was second in the world in 2018, according to Pocket Fives. He won the Sunny Million in 2018 for 160k, the Blowout Series High Roller for 200k, and he has around 2.3 million in cashes. That's only the cashes, and 643k was his largest score. He's a very aggressive player. He understands how to put pressure on his opponents, especially later on in the tournament. He understands that the game changes a little bit. Players might be a bit money scared, and he's really good in taking advantage of that. Number 9, Charles Darwin. I mean, this name truly does not need an explanation. From all of the players on this list, he's probably one of the sickest grinders, or if not the sickest grinders. His name is Simon Mattison. He's from Sweden, Stockholm, born in 1993, 27 years old. Simon is an 8-times number one online player worldwide, according to Pocket Fives, spanning from around 2016 to 2018. This truly speaks for his grinding ability. He dropped out of school at 18 to play poker. He started by grinding micro-sitting goals and switched to tournaments when his bankroll could afford it. He only had 10 six-figure caches. I mean, only, but considering how much he played, truly shows how he's also crushing mid-stakes and just accumulating those medium-sized scores. And his massive numbers were simply built from volume and consistency, which is very remarkable. 60.7 million online caches, 338k his largest score, and 1.4 million live caches, where his biggest score was 337k. As I said, sick grinder, sick volume. He plays very solid preflop. He is definitely also capable of going for a big bluff, a big jam preflop if he thinks the timing is right. He's very, very good in using very good bet sizes with his strong hands, which I think is one of the biggest leaks of low sticks and mid sticks players, that they're not able to extract as much value as they're supposed to. And from what I've seen, again, it's very biased. Certainly all the players have many more strengths, but I want to pick one or two things that I think they do extraordinarily well. It doesn't mean that they suck in all the other areas, just something that stands out, and I think they're doing really, really well. Number 8, Lena 900. His name, Niklas Astedt, also from Sweden, from Savidalen, born in October 21. 1990, so he already has reached the age of 30s. He has been 4-times ranked one online player according to Pocket Fives between 2016 and 2017. He's current number one all-time online caches according to Pocket Fives. He passed Hungarian Peter Belabaski in January 2020. He's been playing online since 2008, so since he's 18 years old, so a lot of experience. And back-to-back V-Cup titles in W-Cup titles in 2020, 3 in total, No Limit Hold'em, 2K, W-Cup, 5K Progressive Knockout, just to name a few. He has 21.7 million in online caches, 430K his largest score, and 1.1 million in live caches. So most of them are not sick live grinders. You can say true online legends. So for Lena 900, he is very aggressive preflop in later stage of the tournament. He also understands to pace it a little down, if that's the right word to say. He doesn't shy away from taking big pre-flop when he sees the chance to put himself in a promising position. He's really ICM aware. He plays final tables very, very solid with his 10 to 15 big blind stack, which is very important when it comes to playing final tables. Number 7, Vea. Artem Vezhenkov, I hope I pronounced it correctly, from Russia. Unfortunately, there are not many infos known. People think, might estimate he's over 30 years old. He started playing poker at the age of 22 because of a seminar at his university. He started with a $50 promotion from PokerStrategy.com. Started on PokerStars and grinded his way up. He's a 3-time winner of the Sunny Million, which is an epic accomplishment. Latest in 2018, he graduated with a degree in political science, is accomplished in sambo and judo, and also is proficient in chess. He's a former worldwide number one on Pocket Fives, currently ranked around 74. He hasn't been so active lately, and he started playing online in 2012, or at least that's where Pocket Fives registered his first scores. Around 10.1 million in online cash, is 457k is largest, and he has 246k in live caches. He is the embodiment of giving zero fucks. He's very creative and he plays for the win. You can see it when he might not necessarily always follow ICM. He really wants to win the tournament. He plays his image also really well when having a big hand, and benefits when having a good run, since people will pay him off, which is really important. That's why I always encourage people also to find bluffs. It's not super important. You don't need to have very balanced bluffs in all spots, but I think Vea also really understands the psychology in his opponents, and really is a fearful player that goes after his opponents. So you definitely don't want to have him on your table. Number 6, Wattenlos Christopher Rudolph, from Austria, born in 1988, 32 years old. At his fourth WSOP final table, Christian Rudolph has finally claimed his first bracelet in event 70, the 25k Norman Hole and Poker Players Championship, for 1.8 million, a massive score. He has accumulated many more scores, but this is of course the biggest score. He has 4.6 million in live caches. His online results are hidden. Very sick grinding skills, very straightforward and very solid preflop. This sounds very boring, but I think being solid preflop and having really a good game plan is an incredible strong skill set. He's very ICM aware, quite good at short stacking, and he plays a very exploitative style, which I think is quite important in tournament poker.
Take your game to the next level with a tournament masterclass. Enroll now at RaiseYourEdge.com. The tournament masterclass. Let's crush.
Number 5, NASA 114, also known as João Vieira, from Portugal, beautiful island Madeira, born in July 27th, 1989, age 31. He's been playing poker even before 21. First live cash ever was the main event. Came up playing online and plays a balance of live events and online tournaments. Scoop player of the year, has 4 scoop titles, played pro basketball from 2010 to 2012. He quit to pursue poker, but the discipline of basketball helped him in poker, according to Jeff Gross podcast. It's hard to find his exact online winnings, but around 3.8 million in live caches, 758k is largest score. He's very, very experienced in playing final tables, therefore a strong understanding of ICM. Very good in playing post-flop. From my experience, he's not doing a lot of mistakes, so he plays the early stages of a tournament incredibly well, sets himself in a position to have a lot of deep runs, and that's why you see him being in the mix on these bigger final tables or higher final tables very, very frequently. Number 4, Amadi 017, Adrian Mateos. I don't think this guy needs any introduction. From Spain, Madrid, resides in London. He's born July 1st, 1994, 27 years old. Was at the top of the poker world rankings for 20 weeks in a row from November 2017 to April 17th, 2018. Named as one of the 50 best poker players in history at 2019 WSOP. 27th on the all-time live money list, not on Pocket Fives. In 2013, at only 90 years of age, he won the WSOP Europe main event for 1 million euros. Adrian went on to win two more bracelets at the World Series in Las Vegas in 2016 and 2017. Cashes, he has around more than a million on PokerStars. There is not really a lot of information found, but you can be sure it's multiple millions of dollars. 21.3 million live earnings or cashes and 1.3 million his largest score. His biggest strength lies in his very theoretical sound approach to the game. He is really good in different stack sizes. He doesn't really have a big leak in like a shorter stack or a very specific stack size at all. He plays all the stack size really solid, really good in playing post flop. He makes very little mistakes and seems to be good in all aspects of the game. Yeah, which is an incredible strong skill set in tournament poker in these days. It's not about mastering a few areas, rather being solid and good in all areas. He's not shy in making big hero calls. He's not money scared. So someone you also don't want to have on your table. Number three, Meg Zhang, also known as Michael Zhang, from UK, Nottingham, born in 1995, 25 years old. And despite his young age, already very accomplished poker player. He reached number two in the world in 2018 in Pocket Fives. At age 16, he used to sneak out of his parents' house to play $10 tournaments at his local casino. Had a passion for the game, always wanted to be playing. Final table 5 W Cup events and one of them was a math major who dropped out to play poker full time. Finished 6th in Triton High Roller Series main event for 711,000 euros. Won Super High Roller at Party Poker Mainz, Germany in 2018 for almost a million. He has around 4.5 million online caches, probably even more than that. Not all of the screen names from all poker sites are known. 3.54 million in live and also almost a million here for his biggest score. Very, very aggressive player in the later stages of the tournament. Very hard to play against. He is very creative, uses different bet sizings, and he will find bluffs in most spots. So someone who will have to also hero call sometimes lighter in certain spots, place the highest buy-ins. He won't be scared later on and certainly plays for the win as well, and definitely not the guy you want to have on your immediate left. Number two, Fish 2013, Mikita Baciakuski, I hope I pronounced it correctly, from Belarus, born February 6, 1992, 28 years old. He began playing live tournaments in 2010 at the age of just 18, playing on PokerStars since 2010. Started playing chess when he was 5 years old, but switched to poker when his love of gambling started. At just 12 years old, he started betting on sports with friends, which was his main interest until he found poker at 16. Mikita earned his first million playing poker by 18. He has always loved games and strategy and loved that he could gamble and actually win lots of money. His girlfriend is also a professional poker player from Iran. He won huge live tourneys, the Triton Super High Roller Series main event for 5.257 million Hong Kong dollars, the Triton Super High Roller main event for 2.5 million, both in 2018. He won EPT Online number 6, the 10K for 220K, been active for years and is assumed to have won millions online. Online caches are private, but he won 28.4 million live, 2.5 million larger. So the Triton High Roller event there that he won for 5.25 million. So it's dollars, I guess. So not Hong Kong dollars. So yeah, a lot of money. Incredible strong when it comes to short stack and ICM, which might be a surprise to many, but if you didn't know, he has been playing a ton of sitting goals. We also have been playing a lot against each other, therefore gathering a lot of experience in ICM spots. He's one of the, at least what I would consider, one of the strongest players when it comes to ICM, and combined with his cash game background, thus having a huge edge post up on the field as well, makes him one of the top MTT players in the world. Number one, guess who it is? Pause the video for now, and I really would like to know, what do you think? Who I believe is currently, according to my opinion, the best tournament player in the world. It's also in this list, I didn't consider any friends or people that I know, basically that I don't know personally or I don't have to deal. So the list would certainly look a little different if I would consider my friends. But here, number one, from Australia, born in 1994, age 26, You might have guessed it, I'm Luckbox, Mike Adamo. We have been battling a lot recently. He won the WCoupe 13, $5,000 in 2019 for 250K. He won the WSOPC $400 New Year Colossus in 2021 for his first circuit ring. He won the Sunday Main in September 2019 for 250K and many, many, many more scores. He ran up in the 100K Super Roller Bowl, the online event for 1.2 million last year. Cashes are unknown, but has multiple 6 to 7 figure scores on PokerStars and GG, 8.3 million in live cashes. Extremely aggressive and creative, especially in his bet sizings. From all of the players, he's certainly the most creative and also the most aggressive. Smartly aggressive, I would say. There are a lot of aggressive opponents, but it's not a good aggressive approach what they're playing. It's also really hard to be aggressively good and understanding which spots to pick. He understands when to be aggro, but also understands when to slow down. He has a very good intuition and has a very good timing. Puts enormous pressure on his opponents and is excellent playing his image very well and squeezes the maximum amount of value from his strong holdings when his opponents have a hard time folding against him. That's something he does really well when he knows, okay, this is a spot where it's unlikely my opponent's going to be folding. That's where he's putting so many more chips. He's putting so many more chips on top to squeeze out some extra value. Definitely a guy you don't want to have on your final table, especially not on your left side. I have one more player for you, some sort of a bonus, someone that I really look up to, an incredible strong player. But he has been playing more live, but he definitely deserves to be on this list. Stevie444, Steven Chidwick from England, resides in Playa del Carmen, Mexico, born May 10th, 1989, age 31. He began playing poker online 2006, playing as Stevie444 and Tyler's Dad 64. Built his bankroll entirely from free roll tournaments on PokerStars and folded. And as you can see, all of these sickos, they have been grinding their way up. Nothing was gifted from the micros up onto the high stakes. They made the experience, they failed, they learned, they tried again, and ultimately they got there. According to an article on Run It Once, he got 11th in the world in online cashes in 2018, won his first WSOP bracelet in 2019 in the 25K PLO high roller for 1.6 million. In 2018, he became the highest ranked player on the GPI rankings. He's number one on England's all-time money list and number six in the world. That's a remarkable accomplishment, especially when you consider also his incredible performances online. He has 34.7 million in live cashes. His best was 5.3 million. And he has 5.3 million in online cashes as well, 156K, his biggest score. Not so much to say about him. He's very experienced in playing post-flop, is very strong when it comes to adjusting his game on his opponents. I mean, by saying not so much to say about, it's just he's really good in everything. I feel like there's really no weakness in his game. I mean, based on his experience, based on his background, it's really hard to have a lot of leaks in your game. He's probably one of the best when it comes to adjusting to his opponents. He really has the ability to deviate from GTO whenever it's necessary. He's very good in avoiding setups and maintaining his stack, which guaranteed many of his deep runs where others would have busted many times. I can't really think of a hand where I punted really hard, but we all have punted in our past in some of the tournaments, and he's very, very good in bluff catching. He also has a sit-and-go background, which of course provides him with the in-depth knowledge for ICM spots, short stacking. You're not gonna find him doing a lot of mistakes on final tables. I really hope you have enjoyed my top 10 list, or actually top 11 with Stevie. Yeah, you can say Stevie and I'm Luckbox being on the top. I couldn't really decide who I want to put on the number one. Stevie, at least online, I haven't been seeing him around, but I would say overall, with his experience, incredible, talented, and experienced players, barely make any mistakes. Also the ability to put on a lot of pressure on his opponents and just I'm Luckbox with his recent results over the last 1 or 2 years, he has to be there on the top. So that's my list. Certainly there are so many more incredible strong players out there. This is just my list. I would like to know from you though, if you would do a top 10 ranking online, considering online and live, more the focus on online. So it should be, of course, they can also have live results. So it's not just explicitly or exclusively online, but main focus should be online. Yeah, I would like to know who would be on your list. Drop a comment and curious to read, curious to see. It's very biased, so let's not start a fight. Oh my God, why did you put him on this on your list? That's kiddie bullshit. It's of course also a matter of taste, what we consider as good in poker. So yeah, let me know, drop a comment, and then see you guys next time.